Hey, what's good, damn it? It's Dak Gum. 7:57, Monday the 26th. And I am not feeling like doing squats. I don't have any motivation other than I need to move some weight. I didn't wake up early enough to do some cardio, but I'm gonna try and fix that with something else. And my back is sore, but the squats are supposed to be easy today. Three by six at 315, which is very doable. I just need to get my ass in there. So, lazy part of me feels that I can do this without knee sleeves. I can do this without the belt, but the way that my lower back feels, I am not properly warmed up. And while this is on my mind, rest in peace, God bless the soul and family for Black Tom Cruise. He wasn't even a YouTuber, just a cool dude that happened to be on Larry Wheels' YouTube page every now and then. And I always liked the guy just because of just how he was. I could tell that if I ever met him, we would be cool. He died in a car accident. Yeah, man, hate to see it. So I just wanted to say that while I was on my head. As far as today goes, my back is stiff. I'm sure if I rolled it, stretch some, it will act right, but I ain't got that much time before I gotta go to work. Before I have to log in and do the thing. And I got a lot of other things that is in the tuck, which should be coming in this week. Some of it I will talk about, such as my Springfield XD40 threaded barrel. It has taken 2 months for this shit to come through. And when I call, I get this woman, and she tells me that it's supposed to be either completed the last week of July, which is now, or it should be shipped the last week of July. Now, of course, I am very impatient, so when I order things, I kind of want them to be shipped the day after. But something like that had to actually be specifically made. And I know that it says some fitting required, which makes me feel like now it might not even fit. I paid all this money for it, and it might not even fit. Which I'm sure when they say fitting required must mean that I might have to Dremel tool some shit, which I kind of don't want to do, but I mean, I haven't had that pistol since 2004. That is older than my oldest daughter. I'm gonna figure it out. I want to see if that comes in this week. I don't want to have to call that lady again, because even though that I've only spoken with her once, which basically has been once every month, the feeling I got from her was that she kind of felt that I was pestering her. All I asked was, I wanted to see what the status was on my order. And I gave her the order number, and she's just like, yeah, it should be completed by the end of July. I'm like, late, man. But this is kind of like the way she said it. It made it seem like she had a slight little attitude, like on a number 2 agitated level. And I'm a customer, you know what I'm saying? I mean, granted, I'm probably not gonna buy anything else for a Springfield, but for her to kind of come off as I was bothering her by asking that question. Marette, what me wrong? It ain't the way that I, it's not the way that I felt, it's the way that she came off. But that's cool, huh? Like I said, I won't be dealing with them anymore. But the good thing is, if the shit don't fit, it doesn't matter because I still have the factory barrel. I got this full of dope. Other thing is, I don't want to talk about that yet, but did order a case of 556. I will be taking out the AR to the next range day, which is Saturday, which I've been telling folks is Sunday. Let me confirm, because I put on my calendar, it's Saturday. So I told a motherfucker it was Sunday. I told many motherfuckers it was Sunday. Don't fucking matter right now. It's time to get in these damn squats. Yeah.
Brought the nigga home behind the wall and now we're
yeah.
We soft.
Where's my belt? I want to see my belt.
We're really not ready for you. We're working on it.
I don't want to hear any excuses. I want to see my belt, and I want to see it now.
It's in pieces.
Get the ham hogs out.
Oh, yeah, man. Gotta clean them before you put them in that pot. You're gonna feel like you're over-exaggerating it, and it's just gonna look pretty normal, really. Like,
yep.
It's 9:05 a.m. I'm late to work. I'm still driving home from the gym. I'm recording on my iPhone because I left the daggum SD card on my camera because I was formatting it. Good thing about the vault is that you have good-ass spotters like Jose who won't even judge you or say something slick or make a face if you ask him to hold your phone and video your reps and sets, because he knows what you're trying to do, and he ain't doing anything else but make you better or make you feel better about being in the gym. So, motherfucking shout out to Jose. I'm gonna have to get his IG and promote him, because he's a solid ass dude, and more folks like him need to be celebrated. But that was a late start this morning. I just stayed in the bed, didn't get up to do cardio, and took a long ass shit, then took the girl to school, and the gym didn't need to, I didn't have to do any barbell movements, more just accessory shit. So I got in the cables, inclines, leg extensions, and got up out of there. But I did get a good ass pump though, man. You can see it right there. Ain't even flexing, but you see how the chains are sitting. So if the chains are sitting like that, it's a good motherfucking pump. Oh, you know what? What is this next to me? I don't know what this is next to me, but they ain't turning, so we might have to race. So their lane ends. Oh no, she gonna turn. I was about to give it to her. Whatever that Dodge Journey was, I'd already put it in tow mode. Let's go and blast that ass. Go ahead and take tow mode off, because my shit is ready for it. But yep, I'm on the way to the house now, and we'll see what else I'm getting into. Yep. Hey, yeah, baby. Wednesday, 8:47. I'm gonna be late to work. I'm trying to head home, wash the dick and balls after doing squats. Man, got the 365 4x3 and felt real good. I don't know where this power was coming from, and I like it. that shit was in there though. Like the way I was feeling, I was feeling confident to just go off program and knock down 4 or 5 with some reps, but nah, like, keep it cool, do what the daggone program says, and when it come time to get to that, then we're gonna get to that. But shit felt great, and last night I did an hour worth of cardio on the bike. I wanna try and do that again, because definitely cutting this weight, seeing the improvement on the way I'm looking in the mirror, and the power is there as well. So shit's going down the way that I want it to as far as things coming in. I got 4 Strike Industries angled front grips, and key emphasis on angle, because if it's a 90 degree right angle, if you put the grip on your gun and it's a 90 degree angle and it's a pistol, then that's a fair violation. ATF, come get that ass. And what I always tell you motherfuckers, avoid the felony. Therefore, you get these Strike Industry pistol grips, front grips, which are like, I think it's like at, see that, 87 or 85% angle. So it's not a complete 90 degree angle. Therefore, you're not violating the ATF law. And I put that on Skeletor, and I put, and Skeletor is the M10X pistol, and then I put one on Gen 5. Gen 5 is an AK-47 rifle, so it doesn't matter, because that's not going to avoid the ATF law. I have 2 more. One, I'm saving for a specific gun that might be in tomorrow, depending on how the FFL does, but the range is usually really good with doing the transfers quickly. And then the other one, I don't even know why I bought another one. Well, I know why I bought another one, just don't know what gun I'm gonna put it on. But I'm sure I got something, and I'll go from there. Then I also got a GoPro gun mount, which is gonna be dope. As long as this motherfucker works, it's gonna be dope to get some good shots of the Galil with the reciprocating handle and facial reactions and just muzzle blast. That should be kind of cool. What else came in? Got a Picatinny red dot riser, because I'm still trying to figure out how to do this can't shit. I bought one. I'm gonna see if that works. And there was something else that gone. Oh shit, one of the main motherfucking things. I got 2 Hollow Sun 512s, red dots. It's the, it'll be in competition with the Vortex Huey, maybe an EOTech. And I'm gonna come here clean to you right now. Those EOTechs that I have were fake. And I'm gonna tell you, I bought fake ones on purpose, because I wanted to see how the guns reacted, and also I wanted to see how I could deal with something like that. I didn't want to, an EOTech is like $600, and I didn't want to buy, you know how many guns I motherfucking got, you see how many I buy a lot. I don't want to spend $1,200, $1,300, $1,400 on a gun and then buy a $600 optic and then buy another $1,200. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got cash like that. So I bought the fake ones just to see, okay, let's just see how it works. Let's see how it acts. Let's make sure the gun works. And a lot of times the guns that I'm getting are not coming with iron sights. So you can't go to the range. I don't think you can go to any gun range here in Austin and shoot your gun without iron, without any type of sight. You have to have some type of optic or some iron sight, something on there. So fuck it. $40, $50 for a little old punk ass fake EOTech, you know what I'm saying? All right, see it, got it, it worked, all right. So now I have replaced every single fake EOTech that I own. I either replaced it with a HoloSun, a Vortex, or a Bushnell, or something else to start with a B. I think a Brunel, something like that. I can't remember. But I ain't spending no daggum $600 fucking dollars on one fucking optic. But I got so many daggum guns. It's just I just ain't built for that. But with all that out the way, you know what I'm saying? The guns work, and the sights work that I have on there. Also, the 512s are solo power, so that's really dope. And I'll tell you one thing that I noticed really quickly with those fake EOTechs is that the reticle is hard to see in sunlight. When I'm in the range and I'm shooting, in the indoor gun range, yeah, it's great. You don't have a problem because it's dark in there, and they have, it's not dark, but they have lighting for an indoor gun range. But when you go outside here in Texas and that sun is daggum 2 p.m. high in the sky, no clouds, and you can't see a motherfucking thing. There's a range video where I took the daggum EOTech off because there was no fucking point. Couldn't see shit. But the 512s are really dope. And I have 510s. But if I need to get another sight, I'm definitely gonna go with another 512. These are really nice looking, and I assume that they're gonna perform really well Saturday. But that's enough of this daggum talking. I'm gonna get to the house and get to work, and then we're gonna do whatever else needs to happen for Wednesday. I think tomorrow I got bench. Man, look, avoid the felony. Don't talk to cops. Don't get fucked. Cops hem you up. Lawyer up. Attorney. You ain't even got to have an attorney to say, I want an attorney. You know what I'm saying? Don't talk to them until you actually see an attorney come through. They slide you a business card or something that lets you know that they are a real deal attorney, because these motherfucking cops will lie their ass off to get you arrested. Their excuse will be like, we're trying to serve the public. Man, them motherfuckers trying to make a career. They're trying to make a career so they can get paid, they can have the glory, they can be praised amongst their peers, get higher pensions, and become a super cop. You know what I'm saying? Don't fall into the bullshit trap that they just out here trying to serve and protect. You know what I'm saying? Maybe them little ass, tiny ass cities where it's like a population of 200 and the cop know every single body. But no, in a city like this, nah, they trying to get you fucked. But hey, I'm going to get back with you. Yeah. Thank you.
Hey, yeah. What is today? Thursday. Right? Yes, Thursday. Yeah. And same thing as yesterday. Headed home 8:50. I gotta go to work at 9. It's gonna take me about a full 10 minutes to get to the house, but be there when I be there. You know what I'm saying? So I need something to eat. Bench press. Had a single at 355, and then 4x3 at 335. Did all right. You know what I'm saying? Not as strong as I would like to be this morning, but it got to where it got to get. And I didn't wake up early enough to do the daggum cardio, but fuck it. You know what I'm saying? Shit, I didn't wake up last night to do the cardio. You know what I'm saying? I had a bad fucking headache, tired and shit, so that didn't happen. I'm gonna try and make it happen today. But bench press was pretty cool with using the Texas Power Bar by the Caps, which is definitely a learning curve from using either a Rogue Bar or the Black Saber Bar from Rep Fitness. I think it's Rep Fitness that I got at the house, and even the Buffalo Bar, because the knurling on a Texas Power Bar is so aggressive that it's not going to spin in your hand. And even if you are sweaty, your hands, your palms are sweaty, you're still going to get a good grip where it's not going to be a problem or some type of a liability of missing the rep with that part. But it's a thicker bar. It doesn't have any bend to it, so the weight that you have on there is no momentum, no kinetic energy from any type of bounce off of your chest versus some of the Rogue Bars that are up there at the vault where they have some flex. You bounce that shit in your chest, you might get a little momentum off of there from that, but not on the Texas Power Bar, so that I like that. But the plan today, hopefully I got one thing coming in from UPS. I keep checking the tracking and they're saying something such as it's arrived, but it's still processing. It's not on the truck yet. Matter of fact, let me check right now. They do give the option to come pick it up at a location, which is kind of the first time I've ever seen that. And depending on how the day goes, I might try and do that. Yeah, it's still saying that shit. It says, so I might try and do the change delivery and pick up, because I want to start working on what I got, what I have today and tonight. And that's possibly one reason why I know that I'm gonna try and force myself to do cardio, because when I could do cardio at night, the kids asleep, the wife is asleep, so then I can start doing things. I got 1,000 rounds of 223 and some AR mags because I'm bringing Bane to the range today. I hadn't shot Bane in a long time, and I want to be loaded up and ready to go with that. And also, another daggum delivery is acting like it ain't going to happen this week. It's coming through post office. I ordered the shit on Monday. I ordered it Monday fucking morning, like 5 in the morning, something like that. And it's still saying it's in California at the post office. Now, I believe that that's just a mistake on the tracking, that it may get here on that Friday, but we'll see. But I really would want that to be here tomorrow so I can finish up. Oh, fuck. Meant to miss that daggum fuck up in the street. And I believe that should be all with everything. And hopefully I don't have anything that just sets me back with what I got planned for Saturday. Everything goes good. Wife and I are talking about some other lucrative options for me to bring in some cash into the family. So I'm talking to some folks. I'm consulting with some people, and gonna figure it out. But I'm gonna get to the house, see what's happening with the work, make something to eat because I'm hungry, and I'm gonna get back with you. Avoid the felony. Yeah.